Okay, let's start out our segment on web design, on web pages, with an introduction to how a web browser displays a web page. Now, this is going to be very simplified. Let's just take a look at how a web browser goes and gets the pieces and assembles them into a web page. There's a lot of detail here that you will spend many quarters as you study this technology. But let's get started. Let's start with our web browser, and we'll call it a client. So we have any client browser, whether it's, I don't know, Chrome or Internet Explorer or Firefox or whatever. You click on a link or you type in a URL. URL stands for Uniform Resource Locator, and the web browser goes out and finds the server that corresponds to the first part of that URL. Now the server takes the URL and finds the file or the other resource that it, whatever you specified, deep in its own file system. So the URL specifies both the server and the actual file that the browser wants to fetch. So the server returns it to the browser. Usually this is an HTML file. So the browser parses the HTML file. Now what parsing means is it looks at each of the pieces of the HTML file, it interprets them, and then it acts on them. HTML contains the content of the web page, the text content, but it also contains information about the structure and links to other files. As you may recall, HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. Hypertext is a word that refers to something that's bigger than just one text file. It links to other files. So these various other files are out on the web, and the browser goes off and fetches any files that are linked to the HTML file. These can be things like other media, like pictures or videos or sounds. That's more content, non-textual content. These can be things like cascading style sheets. Style sheets are information about the appearance of a web page, not the content, but the appearance. What color are things? What fonts are we using? Where are we putting this content on the page? Is the page wide? Is it narrow? All of this appearance information is in the style sheet. Finally, the third part of any web page is the behaviors, and this is usually in JavaScript. Not Java, JavaScript. JavaScript is a way of adding behavior to the web page so the web browser itself can run little programs and do convenient things like making sure you get the right input, showing you additional information if you're curious about something. So, a web page has three parts: HTML and media, that's the content. It has the style sheets, or appearance, and finally it has the scripts, or behavior. Content, appearance, and behavior. So the browser goes off and gets all of these different files, and it combines them all into the document object model, which we'll talk about later, and then it renders this page. Rendering means it draws the page. It draws the page in the window on the web browser. Now the next thing we're going to do is we're going to take a look at each of these files. Your first assignments in this course require you to find these files and to upload them to a web server. And there's a lot of information in these files, and we're going to do a simplified code walkthrough. Code walkthroughs are things that teams do all the time. All of that information and that activity is in the next screencast. So I'll see you over there.